Welcome to the CheckMK channel. Today we want to take a quick look at tags and labels. Labels are in general key value pairs that are really freeform in the end. So the only thing that you have to adhere to is the separation between key and value, but how you name the key and the value is really completely up to you. There is no rules behind that. You can make tiny changes in a label and it's a completely different label. You have all the options that you have there, and you can do it at runtime. You can do it at any time and place in your configuration. On the other end, if we're talking about tags, tags are a distinct set of options. So a tag has a name, a identifier, by which it's referenced. And then you have several options which are predefined or which you have to predefine. And then in the configuration, you can only choose from those options. So you cannot add an option on the fly. There can be no typos because you can only choose one of those options in the configuration. Putting this together in CheckMK, you have labels that are primarily discovered through the data sources. So you have labels telling you that the device is a switch, a firewall, Windows, Linux server, something like that. That's discovered by the data received by the data source, for example, the CheckMK agent or the SNMP agent. And you can also create labels on the fly, let's say based on folders, based on rules, to add your own labels to it. And there is also the possibility to use a service discovery or a process discovery where you find a certain process on a server and based on that, attach a label to that server to identify it. On the other end, using tags, you can, for example, manage the operating system of the server. So even if the label detection wouldn't work or there's no agent there, you can also override that setting and say, I know that this is a Linux server, for example. I'm gonna tell it that this is a Windows server. Or talking about the server role, like a domain controller, maybe database server, something like that, that can be put into labels. There you have a certain set of options that you can choose from with the database example, MySQL, MSSQL, PostgreSQL, MongoDB, for example, whatever there is. And that enables you to manage it from an administrator's point of view. So to put it together, labels are more fluent, more volatile in the end, and can be occur and vanish at any point. Host tags are always there. They can be used at any place in CheckMK, but the set of options is limited, which means there can be no mistakes. If you choose one of the options, it's always the same throughout all the hosts and servers. With that, I'm going to leave you for today. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you around.